What's up, everyone? This is CyberKnight8610, and today we have some Yu-Gi-Oh! News for you guys. Not only have we heard about the OCG imports for Shadow Specters, we now have the last two world premiere cards for Shadow Specters as well. One of them, of course, being the new Noble Knight XC Monster, a card I've been really excited to hear about. So here we go. Its name is Sacred Noble Knight of King Artorias. Of course, it is a, rank 5. It requires two Noble Knight monsters that are level 5 to exceed something into it. It's light, it's warrior, 2,200 attack, 2,200 defense. So, that's the same attack and defense, which is kind of neat. And here's its effect. When this card is exceed summoned, you can target up to 3 Noble Arms equipped spell cards with different names in your graveyard. Equip those targets to this card. Once per turn, you can attach one exceed material from this card, then target one other monster on the field. Destroy that target. If this card on the field is sent to the graveyard, you can target one level 4 or higher Noble Knight monster in your graveyard and special summon that target. So, yeah, I mean, this is actually a really awesome card. Using, of course, Excalibur, and you're able to rank up into this card by using the other Noble Knight XC to do so. And if you have the Noble Arms cards in your graveyard, having three of them, especially three different ones, it gains a lot of effects off the bat because all these different Noble Arms effects will, of course, work for it. And, of course, that can give it, you know, a lot of attack, make it destroy set cards, you know, even protect the card. You know, it just depends on, of course, the Noble Arms that you have in the graveyard. So, you know, that can change things up a lot. Not only that, you can just detach a material and then just target a monster on the field and destroy it. So, that's, you know, even if you aren't strong enough to destroy a certain monster, if there's one getting in your way that's somehow stalling, you can just get rid of it, which is pretty awesome in itself. And not only that, if this card is sent to the graveyard, you know, from the field to the graveyard, then you can get a Noble Knight that is level 4 or higher from your graveyard and special summon it, which you can use for other strategies. Go for, you know, the Synchro Monster, go for a different XC. I mean, just so many different strategies you can do with that. So yeah, first off though, I gotta say, you guys know I'm gonna say this, the artwork is freaking awesome. I'm so glad to hear about this artwork. And I know I've said it so many times, you guys are probably sick of it and me saying it, but I will say it one more time. I think Noble Knights are going to be really awesome after Shadow Specters. I think they're going to be one of the top meta decks, and this card is freaking awesome. And yeah, I can't wait to see what they're going to do. I really can't. It looks like this is going to be an ultra rare card, so not too bad. I'm kind of afraid that the other ones, I don't know if it's been confirmed or not, but a lot of the other Noble Knight cards are like secret rares and stuff, so it's going to be a fun for somebody trying to get them. And not only that, we have the last world premiere card, and that is Bujingi Kornachia. I don't know how you really say it. I think it's also supposed to be called Raven, so I put that too. I mean, I think, so yeah, one or the other. I don't know. That's the best I'm going to be able to pronounce it, I promise you, especially this late at night. Anyway, it is a rare card too, so at least it's not going to be too hard to get for people that want it. It's light, level 4, 1,600 attack, 900 defense, and its effect is when a Bujin monster you control is destroyed by battle with an opponent's monster and sent to the graveyard, you can send this card from your hand to the graveyard, destroy that opponent's monster. Pretty basic effect. I mean, you know, it seems like it could be useful in certain ways. I don't really use Bujin monsters. I've used them a few different times when they were actually called War Gods, I guess. It seems like this card could come in handy for them, but yeah, we'll just have to see. I guess it's nice that it's a rare. So at least we have, I guess, one world premiere so far that's been confirmed as rare. I don't know about the others just yet. So yeah, tell me what you guys think about these two world premiere cards. What do you think of the new Noble Knight? And what do you think of course, this for Bujin monsters? I don't really use Bujin monsters for, you know, myself, so I can't really say either way if this is one of the better ones. I think there are better options out there, but like I said, I'm not really, I don't really use them, so yeah. On Noble Knights, though, I do think the Noble Knight XC is freaking awesome. All the support they're getting is really cool. I'm hoping, even though, you know, they're getting all the support in this pack, I'm hoping this won't be the last of support either. Like, after, you know, Legacy of the Valiant, I'm hoping we'll still have a few more cards for them. It makes me wonder, though, since, you know, now they're just coming out with all these at the same time, there's probably going to be the last Noble Knight, direct Noble Knight support that we're going to see for a while. But yeah, tell me what you guys think on this. Do you think Noble Knights will be one of the top meta decks? And also, do you think this card will really help Bujin monsters? And will they be really strong after the set, too? Because they're getting a lot of support, too. As always, thank you for watching. Remember to comment, rate, and subscribe. And tell me one more thing. What archetype out of this set are you most excited about? There's, of course, you know, it can be something that's coming out new in this set, like Ghostrix or Vampires, or it can be something that's getting support, like Noble Knights or Bujin Monsters. You know, there's just a few examples. I think there's a few others out there, too. So tell me what you guys think on that in the comments. Thank you for watching. Remember to comment, rate, and subscribe. All the info will be in the description, and I will catch you guys later. See ya.